Chapter 955, Huang Yuehong. Sage Jai Uyang's people were lurking everywhere within Phoenix Scry Palace. This meant that all those who dared to be hostile against him would be pushed aside. If Fairy Feng herself were here today, then Song Beifeng wouldn't even dare to say a single rude word. Otherwise, that would be offending a vice palace master and Fairy Feng would have the authority to punish him on the spot. However, Juninru and her group had no choice but to swallow this insult. In the end, she was just too weak. Her cultivation was only at the early Divine Sea. Even if her talent far surpassed this Song Beifeng in front of her, she still wasn't his match at this moment. As for the disciples behind Juninru, they were only at the 7th and 8th stage of life destruction or at the half-step Divine Sea. They weren't any better. They would be instantly defeated by Song Beifeng. Lin Ming wasn't any better either. His cultivation was only at the 5th stage of life destruction while Song Beifeng was an 8th stage life destruction late Divine Sea realm martial artist, far superior to the early Divine Sea Yang Yun. Though we could only allow themselves to be suppressed everywhere, Song Beifeng, I will remember this. Juninru took out a jade book from her spatial ring. After opening the book, one could see pages covered with rows upon rows of dense red seal marks, as if they were phalanxes of tadpoles. These were Phoenix Cry seal marks, a type of contribution point that Phoenix Cry Palace recorded for their disciples. Every contribution point was a single Phoenix Cry seal mark, and they could be transferred or traded to others. Because many resources at Phoenix Cry Palace required Phoenix Cry seal marks to purchase or access, they were much more welcomed by the disciples than Violet Sunstones, a type of currency that was always in demand. Juninru waved her hand and several thousand red seal marks left the jade book. At this moment, a rich and compelling voice suddenly sounded out. Isn't that junior apprentice sister Juninru? Everyone turned to see a spirit boat flying towards them. This spirit boat was carved from priceless jade and it was being towed by 9 golden crows. At the bow of this spirit boat, an elegant youth in embroidered robes slowly flew down, accompanied by 2 others behind him, both of which had a late divine sea cultivation. The elegant youth held a folding fan, his feet stepping atop an auspicious cloud. Motes of light faintly floated around him as if he were an immortal exiled from heaven. This youth's cultivation was deep like the sea, and his appearance was extraordinarily handsome. He emitted a kingly atmosphere from head to toe, making one feel awed in his presence. If this person were described within a world of mortals, then he would be a naturally born emperor. Whether it was his temperament, aura, or appearance, everything he possessed was so. Huang Yugong, senior apprentice brother Huang. As Song Beifeng and the other guards of St. Artifact Pavilion saw this elegant youth, they were surprised for a brief moment before revealing flattering smiles. They hurriedly jumped off their fire lions to greet him. To dismount when greeting someone was an expression of respect, otherwise it would give off a commanding and superior feeling. When Song Beifeng faced Juninru and the others, he didn't step off his mount, but now he rapidly dismounted. It was clear that this person had a noble status. Who is that? Lin Ming couldn't help but ask with a true essence sound transmission. Although he could feel that this elegant youth had an early divine sea cultivation, he could feel that his aura was vastly different from others. In other words, he was an extremely terrifying individual. Juninru took a deep breath and said, "That is Phoenix Hall disciple Huang Yugong. He has a 9th stage life destruction divine sea cultivation. Don't look at him being at just the early divine sea realm. In true battle, his strength even surpasses Song Beifeng. His foundation is absolutely solid, and in the future he even has great hopes of becoming a character on the level of a divine lord. Moreover, after reaching the divine lord realm, the inner world he creates will be far larger than others. It might hold mountains, rivers, seas, and even stars. Oh? Phoenix Hall? 9th stage of life destruction." Lin Ming's thoughts stirred. Phoenix Hall was the highest rank of disciple, equal to a core disciple. He deeply gazed at Huang Yugong. Besides Fairy Feng and a few others, this was the first time he truly saw a 9th stage life destruction powerhouse. A 9th stage life destruction powerhouse was indeed far more horrifying than an 8th stage life destruction martial artist. Juninru continued, "Not only is Huang Yugong strong, but his background is the Huang family clan. The Huang family clan is one of the 3 great family clans of our ancient Phoenix clan, along with the Huo family clan and the Zhao family clan. Within Phoenix Cry Palace, the ones that cannot be provoked are these types of individuals, those that are extremely strong and also come from prominent noble families. That is the reason why Song Beifeng flatters him like this." "I see," Lin Ming said, suddenly aware. This sort of person was strong and their roots were deep. Offending them would often lead to a miserable outcome. Only they were allowed to step on others. No one would dare move against them. Could he also be in Sage Jai Uyang's faction? Juninru said, "The Huo, No, and Huang family clans intensely compete amongst each other, but in the ancient Phoenix clan, they're all connected through various divisions of benefits. They'll certainly support the juniors of the 3 great family clans over others. In Phoenix Cry Palace, the Huang family clan supports the Zhao family clan, and in some other palaces, the Zhao family clan will support the Huang family clan. This Huang Yugong is also one of Sage Jai Uyang's people. He hasn't grown too strong now, but in the future once he reaches divine transformation or even the divine lord realm, he will definitely become a big boost to Sage Jai Uyang's position." Lin Ming understood the approximate situation about Huang Yugong at Phoenix Cry Palace. Although he was only a junior for now, he would inevitably shine in the future, blooming into brilliance. Huang Yugong didn't land on the floor, instead staying floating in the air. As he watched Juninru and the others, his expression and eyes were just like a king overlooking his subjects. The other disciples behind Lin Ming drew back several steps. Against such a character they lacked the energy to withstand the tremendous pressure. In the end, They came from humble origins and were ordinary themselves. In the face of someone from the ancient Phoenix Clan's noble Huang family clan, they naturally felt awe and fear. Someone that ascended from the lower realms. Huang Yugang instantly discovered Lin Ming and his eyes swept through him. Lin Ming felt a perception rush through his body like a vast and surging tide, as if all his secrets were being flipped over. However, this feeling left just as fast as it came, lasting only for the briefest of moments. After, Huang Yugang ignored Lin Ming as if he hadn't seen him at all, instead treating Jun Yinru and the two other female disciples to a bright smile. Junior apprentice sister Jun, how are you? Are you here to find a saint artifact? If junior apprentice sister Jun needs a saint artifact, in truth you only needed to speak to me. Here, I just happen to have a good saint artifact here that is for women to use. It would be better served in the hands of junior apprentice sister Jun. Huang Yugang flicked his hand and a bracelet flew toward Jun Yinru. This bracelet seemed as if it was forged from starlight. In an instant, it wrapped around her hand without leaving her the chance to react. This also reflected the vast disparity of strength between Huang Yugang and Jun Yinru. As the twinkling silver bracelet was worn on Jun Yinru's wide arms, it was especially beautiful. This is a low-grade saint artifact? Jun Yinru's eyebrows shot up. As she looked at her hand, an incredulous expression was etched on her face. She wanted to decline it but she hesitated instead. Yes, that is a low-grade saint artifact called the Chain of Stars. If you wear it, it has the effect of nourishing your soul. Moreover, when you revolve your true essence it will enhance your strength by 10%. Huang Yugang said with a smiling face. A saint artifact was very precious and many disciples of Vermilion Bird Hall didn't even have one. An accessory-type saint artifact was several times more valuable than other types of saint artifacts. A low-grade saint artifact bracelet far surpassed an ordinary medium-grade offensive saint artifact in value. For instance, Lin Ming's saint artifact bracer was able to increase his perception. It played an extremely helpful supporting role when he was comprehending laws. This was one of the more prized treasures he had obtained from the Temple of Marvels. The bracelet Huang Yugang just casually gifted wasn't much worse than Lin Ming's saint artifact bracer. It was extremely difficult for Jun Yinru to decline this gift. She really liked this bracer. Moreover, the use of this bracer was amazing. With it, Jun Yinru's strength would increase and she could rise even quicker and enter Phoenix Hall, becoming a core disciple. Huang Yugang chuckled. Junior apprentice sister Jun, this bracelet looks beautiful on you, as if it were custom made for your wrists. Jun Yinru's appearance was exceptional. Her chest was full and seductive and her legs were straight and slender. Her butt and thighs curved up deliciously, and her expression was usually stern. Due to her beauty, this sternness actually contained a beguiling charm. Because of this, Jun Yinru was also exceedingly appealing even in the ancient Phoenix clan where beauties were present like clouds. She attracted the attention and pursuit of many men. Moreover, Jun Yinru was favored by Fairy Feng and her talent was good. Although she was currently in the Golden Crow Hall, in truth she could enter the Vermilion Bird Hall whenever she pleased. It wouldn't even be a problem for her to enter the Phoenix Hall in the future. Her prospects were bright and shining. The action of Huang Yugang sending out this bracelet was obvious in its meaning. Behind Jun Yinru, Lin Junzai and the other female disciple looked on with expressions full of envy. As Huang Yugang saw the two young women's responses, he faintly smiled and said, although this is my first time meeting these two fellow junior apprentice sisters, our meeting can also be considered a stroke of fate. Here are two low-grade saint artifact swords. Consider them a meeting gift. Huang Yugang waved his hands and two saint artifact swords shot out. These two swords sparkled with a bright light, sharp and cold. One could see they were excellent swords at first glance. As Lin Ming saw these two swords, he couldn't help but sigh at just how shamefully and excessively wealthy Huang Yugang was. Out of all the swords he had seen throughout his life, besides the argent white sword surpassing these two swords in quality, all other swords were like scrap metal in comparison. This. As Lin Junzai received this sword, her cute face blushed red. She never thought that Huang Yugang would gift such a precious gift on their first meeting. She came from a humble mortal background, so where could she ever obtain a saint artifact? And now someone actually gifted her this divine sword, how could she not be amazed? Behind Lin Junzai, the other male disciples had expressions thick with envy. They licked their lips and looked at Huang Yugang, hoping that he would also gift them something. As Lin Ming saw their eyes, he shook his head. As for Huang Yugang, his eyes flashed with a trace of disdain. He folded his hands together, holding no meaning of giving them anything. Behind Huang Yugang, one of his two subordinates laughed heartily. These two idiots, who do they think they are? Young master gave the sister apprentices saint artifacts because he favors them. Especially that Jun Yinru, she is truly a top quality woman. Those two ridiculous fools, they have the face of a slave. Have they ever even looked in a mirror? It's like they really think they're in high demand or something. The other subordinate said, this also can be helped. Yan Feng Xian came from a common origin, so the disciples she gathers are mostly from the same common origin. To the poor, an ordinary saint artifact can have their eyes go red with jealousy.